Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Please join me. For work I will use 1.4mm crochet hook and a ball of 100% mercerized cotton yarn. 169 meters and 50 grams. And I'm using seed beads. Before the work I threaded seed beads onto the working yarn. You can choose any kind of beads and any colors. It depends on your project. And all additional information about the tools could be found in the description of each video tutorial. And in today's video tutorial, you will see how to crochet amazing cord with puff stitches, seed beads, and slip stitches. This is a double-sided cord. And let's get started crocheting. It is going to be a very interesting project. I will begin from the foundation ring. Make a chain of 5. Let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well done. And join the chain in the round by making a slip stitch into the first chain stitch. My foundation ring is ready. Let's crochet the first segment. Chain of 2, yarn over the hook. Insert the hook into the ring. And pull up the working loop to the level of the chain. So my string is ready. In total it should be 7 of them. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well done. Then yarn over, pull through all loops on the hook except the last one. I have got 2 loops on the hook. Then I draw some seed beads. Before the work, I threaded seed beads onto the working yarn, as I told you before. I need 3 seed beads. Then yarn over, pull through all loops on the hook. Then chain of 7 for the chain space 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Insert the hook into the ring. Make a slip stitch. Pull it. Make a chain. I will turn the work in one direction. Insert the hook into the chain space, make a slip stitch. I will alternate with slip stitch and chain. In total it should be 11 of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. I don't do the chain. Make chain of 2. Yarn over the hook, insert the hook into 2 chains, pull up the working loop to the level of the chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. As I did before, then yarn over, pull through all loops on the hook except the last one. Draw 3 seed beads. Then yarn over, pull through all loops on the hook. Then chain of 7 for the chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Insert the hook into two chain space, make a slip stitch, make a chain, turn the work. Work with 11 slip stitches with chain. As I did before, let's count. 1, 2 and chain, 3 and chain, 4 and chain, 5 and chain, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. And I remind you, I don't do the chain. Let's stop and look what I have done. And this is first one, and I completed the second one. So next time, I continue working on my cord, and I will crochet the next segment as I did the second one. Let's crochet one more segment. Make chain of 2. Make strings. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well done. Then yarn nowhere, pull through except the last one. Draw 3 seed beads. Pull through. My puff stitch is ready. Make chain of 7 for the chain space. I said it before. 1. 2. Let's repeat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well done. Insert the hook into the chain space. Make a slip stitch. Make a chain. Turn the work. Work into the chain space, make a chain and slip stitch 11 times. Let's count them. 1 and chain. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. My third segment is ready. Here how it looks. All segments will be the same. So make chain of 2. And make strings, and so on. So I have done my cord, here how it looks. And now I show you how to complete it. Once I have done the last slip stitch, make a chain, and make slip stitch into the 2 chain space. And chain, chain 2, make slip stitch and chain 3, and make the last one, slip stitch and chain, to secure the yarn by making a chain. So my project is ready. Let's look at the ready project. So that's it, my project is ready. Here how it looks when you are done. This is the back side. This is my O1 pattern I created recently for you. You can use it to create jewelry such as bracelet, necklace, or it could be perfect for hair. You can use your favorite color of yarn and your favorite crochet hook. This is double-sided lace tape, so you can use both sides. Here how it looks on my hand. All additional information about the tools could be found in the description of each video tutorial. Also, there are a lot of useful links on my video tutorials in the description, so please visit the description of each video tutorial. Please write comment below this video what you will get with me and where you will use my patterns and what you will get with me. See you next time. Good luck in crocheting. Please like my video and share with your friends. And bye.